تخطيب حبيبه صلى الله عليه وسلم بقوله تبارك وتعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. ثم شرف المؤمنين بقوله تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم لبيك وسعديك، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأهوال والآفات، وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات، وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات، وترفعنا بها عندك أعلى الدرجات، وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات، إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. Praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has spread the fragrance of his beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in the heavens and in the earth with his statement, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Surely Allah and his angels send salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah Azza wa Jal ennobled the believing people with his statement, O you who believe, send salutations and peace upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it is a due. So say, As-salatu wa s-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulallah. As-salatu wa s-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Habiballah. As-salatu wa s-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rahmatan lil alameen. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lord of the heavens and the earth. And we ask him to send his peace and blessings upon our master Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by whom he has made each and every one of us honored with his statement, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best of people who were taken out for people. This goodness, this khayriyah, which is mentioned in this verse, is by extension of the goodness of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. For who are we of a people that Allah says to us, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. If it wasn't for that beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we would not have been granted that khayriyah that Allah Azza wa Jal placed in this ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as time progresses towards the end of time, we find that calamities and difficulties and tribulations are increasing and increasing. But we should never forget that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, when he said, وَعِسْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةَ كَهَاتَيْنَ, I and the hour was sent like these two. And he gathered between his index and his middle finger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oftentimes we hear this hadith, and the concentration of this hadith is upon the hour that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I and the hour was sent like these two. And what's indicated is that the hour is close, but what our attention is not directed towards, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I and the hour was sent like these two. So you have nothing to worry about if I am with you sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ana, bu'istu ana, I was sent alongside the hour. Why? To make the difficulties and the hardships and the tribulations of the hour easy for you through me sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So the tribulations and the difficulties that come down upon this ummah, they have that giant sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam who bears those difficulties and tribulations, and then those difficulties and tribulations come out to us with ease and comfort. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If this Quran was to be revealed upon mountains, they would have become dust. So how was it that me and you and all of us were able to recite this majestic Quran? The ulama say how we were able to recite this Quran is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِمِسَانِكَ. Allah said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have made this majestic Quran easy through your noble tongue sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So once the Quran was revealed to his heart and his blessed tongue recited it, it became easy for all of us to recite the Quran al-Kareem. We have to remember the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have to remember him in our hearts and in our homes. I was in Madinatul Munawwara
the city of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal, Rabi' al-Anwar in the year 2000. And I heard from our teacher, the great Allama, Shaykh Muhammad Iwad rahimahullahi alayhi, who spent the last 30 to 40 years of his life in Madinatul Munawwara besides the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therein he passed away and he was buried in Jannatul Baqiyah. He said, once upon a time there was a woman, an elderly woman. This is exactly how the Shaykh said it. He said, once upon a time there was an elderly woman and she was my grandmother. And she was terminally ill, extremely ill. She was bedbound. I came to her and I said, Ya Ummah, O mother, should I not bring a doctor for you? Should I not bring a physician for you? And my grandmother said to me, son, leave it, come back tomorrow. So I said, fine. I didn't order for a physician to come. I came back the next day and I was shocked to see that my grandmother was walking. I was shocked to see that my grandmother was bedbound for so long. She was walking, she was moving, she was off her bed. I said, oh mother, I ask you by Allah, how was it that this happened? And she said, oh son, last night when you asked me for a physician, I said to myself, is his physician better than my physician, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So I said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, if you have ever accepted a single salawat of mine upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then grant me cure. She said, when I made this dua the first time, my hand moved. When I made this dua the second time, my other hand moved. When I made this dua the third time, my foot moved. And like this, all night I was praying this dua. By the end of the night, my entire body moved. So she said to him, tell me, is my physician better or yours? Without a doubt, her physician was better. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa baraka wa sallam. This Shaykh, this same teacher of ours, Shaykh Muhammad Iwad, rahmatullahi alayhi, he taught us gems, he taught us wisdoms that are beneficial for all of us, not only when we are in the masjid, but when we are back at home. When we are back at home. He said to us that all of the blessings and all of the goodnesses and all of the success that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed me in my life was due to something very important in my house. And what was that important point in his house? He said, all of the goodness that Allah showed me in my life is due to when I was a small boy and I used to come back from school. Listen to this carefully. And this is how our home should become once we leave gatherings like this. He said, when I used to come home after school as a young boy, he said, my mother used to say to me, son, you see this pot of food that I have cooked for you? It has been cooked over 1,000 salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, my mother would recite 1,000 salawat whilst cooking food for me, and my body was nurtured upon salawat and durood sharif upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And by virtue of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed me all of the success and all of the blessings that I saw in my life. Homes have to become center points for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they would invite the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to their homes. They would invite the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to their homes. And when he would arrive sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would request and ask and say, Messenger of Allah, we would like for you to pray in our house. We would like for you to pray in our house so that we take that place where you stand and pray. We make that our musalla, our place of prayer in seeking blessings from where your blessed foot touches. In seeking blessings from the place where your blessed foot touches. The question is, how many of us and how many of our homes are prepared for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If we had the opportunity today to request and say, Messenger of Allah, the door of my home is open for you. Please come and visit. How many of our homes are prepared and ready for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? عليه وسلم when he becomes missing in our homes, when he does not be the center point of our homes, when our children don't wake up saying as-salatu was-salamu alayka ya Rasul Allah, when they don't go to sleep saying as-salatu was-salamu alayka ya Rasul Allah, then the calamities will strike, and they will strike hard. The difficulties will come, and they will come hard. And when they come hard, there won't be no prophet to save us then. Because we did not prepare our homes for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our teacher, the great Allama of Damascus, Sheikh Usama al-Rifa'i, he said, my father, the great Allama Sheikh Abdul Karim al-Rifa'i rahmatullahi alayhi, when he would take us, his children and his students, out on a picnic, he would take Qasidatul Burda al-Sharifa with him. And he would say to us, recite the Qasida. And once we had recited the Qasida, he would say, now dramatically analyze the Qasida. He said, our picnics were over, praises upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our parties were over, praises of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, were illuminated at night through Mawlaya salli wa sallim da'iman abada ala habibika khayri al-khalqi kullihimi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to walk at night in the streets of Medina. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, remember the streets of Medina had no street lamps. The only lamp that Medina had was the blessed face of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when I passed through the streets of Medina, he said, إِنِّي لَأَعْرِفُ بُيُوتَ الْأَشْعَرِيِّينَ مِنْ قِرَاءَةِ الْقُرْآنِ. He said, I could recognize the houses of the family of Ash'ariyin through what? Through music, through things that come on the screen, through internet. No, he said, I can recognize the homes of the people of Ash'ariyin min qira'ati al-Qur'an, from the recitation of the Qur'an which I can hear from within their homes. O people of Islam, O lovers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, our homes have to become homes in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is invited. And homes in which he is invited are not homes upon screens indecency is seen. Homes in which haram is not seen. Homes in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is remembered. Look at the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We can learn how the house of the Prophet was from the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is how the Prophet's house was. He said, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ, instruct your family, i.e. your wives, the people in your household, with what? وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ, with prayer. وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا, and be consistent upon that. لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا, we don't ask you for provision, for risk. Why? نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ, we are the providers. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, I am the provider. Rizq comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our job at home is to fill the hearts of the people of our home with the love of Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the house of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, as a great Allama and Imam of Hadith, Sheikh Abdullah Sirajuddin radiyallahu anhu mentions in his famous work on the Shama'il, in a footnote in the first chapter, he says that Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, his son showed dislike towards a particular food that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to like. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr said to him, how dare you dislike a food that the Messenger of Allah used to like? This is how the homes of the Sahaba were. This is how the homes of the people who loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were. Homes from which Quran could be heard. Homes from which salawat could be heard. Homes that were illuminated with the nur of Islam. O people, we have to reconsider our position. We have to look back at our homes and see, are they homes in which the Prophet will be welcomed? that we have. That's the only savior that we have. One of our teachers, a student came to him and said, Sayyidi, I want to get married. He said, Sayyidi, I want to get married. He said, fine. He said, when you find a woman and you want to propose to her, I'll give you a question to ask her. Listen to this question. He said, ask her, can you cook the way your mother cooks? He said, ask her, can you cook the way your mother cooks? And the student was, he giggled like all of us, right? So he went, and then he proposed to a woman, to a young girl. And the question that he asked was the question that the sheikh told him to. So he said to her, can you cook the way your mother cooks? And the girl said, no. Big deal. Who cares? McDonald's is down the road. Yeah. Al Rock, you have one takeaway after the other. Lady put on this side, control this side, strike on this side, you name it. Big deal. I can't cook the way my mother cooks. He said, well, I can't marry you. Strange. Why? My sheikh said. So he went and asked the sheikh. He said, Sayyidi, what's the reason that I shouldn't marry a woman who can't cook the way her mother cooks? Listen to this answer. People of Islam, listen to this answer. What did the sheikh say? The sheikh said, a young girl who cannot cook the way her mother cooks, it means that she was not nurtured in her house and by her mother. She was nurtured on the net. She was nurtured on Facebook. She was nurtured on Twitter. She was nurtured on the streets. She was not nurtured by a woman, a pious woman in a home. And now what do we have? Our mothers cook at home. We don't like the food. I eat this every day. Let's order. Let's order from outside. You leave the food of your mother, who washed her hands, perhaps made wudu, said bismillah before she was cooking, and you prefer the food of people whom you don't know whether it was their sweat in that food or their snot. And you prefer that over the food of your mothers. This is our religion, O people, that we honor our mothers in our homes. It's also very easy coming out. But if our homes are not places in which our mothers are honored, Rasulullah would never be happy. Because he said to the young man, Ummuk, thumma ummuk, thumma ummuk, thumma abak. Your mother, your mother, your mother, then your father. Our homes have to become homes in which when food is cooked, it's cooked upon as-salatu was-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah. And that food is not dismissed, but our children eat that and they prefer that of any food that was cooked in the shops, cooked in the takeaways, cooked in the fast food places where the food is not junk, but perhaps those who are cooking it were junk. You should never call food junk, because there are millions of people across the world dying just to have a morsel of food. But we sit in our homes and we give preference to the food that's cooked on the streets to the food that was cooked by our pious mothers. Why? We have to take the Prophet into our homes. And if the Prophet comes into our homes, then the first thing that the Prophet will teach us, that the greatest people for you in your life is your mother and your father, beyond everybody after the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what I'm going to leave you with is pots of food that are cooked upon salawat. People who are nurtured by women, i.e. mothers, in their homes with piety. Look at the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why do we go far? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Ahzab, the same surah in which Allah said, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. In the same surah, Allah said to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنْ وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ الْأُولَى وَأَقِمْنَ الصَّلَاةِ وَآتِينَ الزَّكَاةِ وَأَطِعْنَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Allah said to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to our mothers, as a lesson for our wives, our daughters, our sisters, and our mothers, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنْ. Take comfort in your homes. and peace in your homes. And do what? Getting bored, nothing to do. Why are you getting bored for? Why don't you do the same thing that Allah instructed the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do at home? And what was that? Take comfort and peace in your homes. Wa aqimna as-salah, and establish your prayer. Wa atina az-zakah, and pay your zakah. Wa ati'na Allah wa rasulah, and obey Allah and His Messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَاذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Allah said to the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, and revise, and remember, and study. Revise, remember, and study what? وَاذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ. Recite that which is being revealed in your homes. Ayat the Quran al-Kareem. And وَالْحِكْمَةِ, and the words of the Prophet ﷺ. And salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we're here gathered today to send salawat upon the best of creation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we shouldn't leave from this gathering except that we take the Prophet to our home sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Except that our homes become places where he is most welcome sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is welcome to enter at any point of the day, and he will be pleased to come in sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The homes of the believing people have to become museums of love for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the galleries of which only show the jamal of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such jamal that any eye that falls upon that jamal once will never want to see anything after. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.